G'day Knuckleheads, Uncle Knackers here. I don't know about you, but I listen to a lot of talkback radio on my mobile phone. It must drive my wife nuts. But the only thing is that it's not loud enough, and that drives me nuts. So what I've decided to do is to build a wooden amplifier for my mobile phone. Now, this is very, very exciting because I've managed to be able to source some timber, don't ask me how, that was grown supposedly in the cold period between 1645 and 1715. And it's the exact same timber that the great Italian master craftsman Antonio Stradivari used to build his incredible Stradivarius violins. Now, it's incredibly rare and so, so expensive. And I'm just waiting on now for a phone call from my supplier. And tick of the clock. G'day mate, how'd you go? None left. So what have you got? Pallet wood? Even better, I'll take it. Now the phone amplifier is going to be my entry into the Sterling Davis Pallet Up Challenge. And it's so easy to make. All we need is one length of pallet wood and cut that into three lengths of 245 millimeters, or about 9 3/4 inches. And here are the three pieces that I've just cut. The face plate, the middle plate, and the back plate. The back plate remains untouched, but we need to do some work on these two here. Now the first thing we need to do is to mark out on the face plate where we want the phone to sit and the position of our speaker. Now I've already pre-marked my piece out, and you can see that the phone is sitting 30 millimeters in from the edge, which is 1 3/16. There's a gap here of 30 millimeters, which is 1 3/16, and then the speaker hole, which is 89 millimeters, or 3 1/2 inches, and we're left with 30 millimeters, or 1 3/16 at the end. And you can also see that I've left some of the phone sitting above the top of the box here. That's so that we can still access these controls. Now all we need to do is to cut the phone shape out and the hole for the speaker. It's now time to drill the hole for the speaker. And you'll notice how I've also clamped on the middle plate underneath the face plate. That way, when the hole gets drilled, both will line up beautifully. Now, I'm using a hole saw, like I said before, but you could use a jigsaw if you wanted to. This is a pretty cheap hole saw, and you can get all of this, hang on a sec, all of that, for about $19, so it's pretty affordable, and you'll end up with a nice clean finish. Too easy. So here's the faceplate all done. Now all we need to do is get the sound to travel from the phone to the speaker. And to do that, turn the faceplate around and you'll see where I've marked in a channel, which we'll route out with a router, and hopefully the sound will travel down that channel and into that speaker box. Cross your fingers. With the sound channel all routed in, it's looking pretty good. Now all we need to do is duplicate that sound channel onto the middle or the second piece and then router that out. And the reason for that is that we want the sound to go deep into the speaker so the sound can then belt out. And for those of you unfortunate enough like myself, not to have a purpose-built router table, it's pretty difficult to clamp down this piece and then do your routering. So to counteract that, what I do is just put in some nails around various spots around the job, and that holds it in place. So then you can place, did I just say place twice? And then you can put your router on top of the job and do your thing. Works like a charm. And then when you're finished, just lift it off like that. Too easy. So there we go, the second piece is routed out, the front's ready to go, the back's ready to go, and we're almost ready for assembly. But before we do all that, I wouldn't mind putting a logo or something on the back of that speaker. So what I'm thinking about is using this image and through my printer, transferring it onto this label paper and then transferring it again onto the speaker box. See how that goes. So here's the printout on the label paper, and make sure that when you print it out, you do it in reverse, because when you print it on, then it'll come out the right way. Now I want to cut a hole or a circle the same size as that over that logo, then I'll place that on top of the back of the speaker box. Now press that down really hard. Don't move the transfer. And hopefully that print will come off. Done. And there it is. That looks pretty cool. Well, that turned out pretty good. The boom could have gone across a bit to get the exclamation mark in, but oh well. Close enough. Now all we need to do is to glue and clamp the whole unit together. Now just clean all this glue off with a wet rag and then put it in the clamp. Alrighty, it's 24 hours later and that glue should now be well and truly dry. Let's see how it turned out. I reckon that turned out pretty good. I like it. With the boom box all glued up, all we need to do now is trim the ends, give it a sand and finish it off with a bit of a paint job. But I also made a bit of a mistake because I wanted to run a 6mm rounding bit around the edge of that speaker so that you finish up with something like that. But the drama was, or the drama is that on this top piece I routed the speaker channel too deep. So now when I run my router around that, it's going to jut in there and you'll finish up with that, which is a no-no. Oh well, I'll know better next time. And I'm also going to cut a 10 degree angle on the bottom of the amplifier so that the phone doesn't fall out. And to finish it off, I'm just applying a couple of coats of my trusty old clear satin varnish. And here it is, all done. And I reckon it turned out absolutely fantastic. The colours look great, and I think there's only one thing left, and that's to give it the old sound test. Okay, it's the moment of truth. Let's give it a crack. No tricks. Away we go. That's not bad. I like it. Great tip, Knuckles. So I hope you enjoyed and found that video useful. I know I had an absolute ball making it. And to top things off, it cost virtually nothing to make. Now you've got to love that. Now, if you did enjoy the video, please give it the old thumbs up. That's always greatly appreciated. And if you haven't already, please hit that subscribe button. It's just about there. And while you're here, check out my Facebook page at DIY for Knuckleheads. The link's in the description box below. Now, if you do happen to go out and make one of these, I'd love to see it. So you can upload some pictures to my DIY for Knuckleheads Facebook page. Now, don't go just yet. There'll be a few photos going backwards and forwards of the finished product. All right, my day's just about done. Must be time for a cup of tea. So till next time, I'm out of here. Cheers. Thank you.